Art thou my son?
Aye, I thank God, my father and yourself.
Then patiently hear my impatience.
Madam, I have a touch of your condition which cannot brook the accent of reproof.
Oh, let me speak.
Do then, but I'll not hear.
I will be mild and gentle in my speech.
And brief, good mother, for I am in haste.
Art thou so hasty? I have stayed for thee, God knows, in anguish, pain, and agony.
And came I not at last to comfort you?
No, by the holy rood, thou knowest it well. Thou camest on earth to make the earth my hell. A grievous burthen was thy birth to me. Tetchy and wayward was thy infancy. Thy school days frightful, desperate, wild, and furious. Thy prime of manhood, daring, bold, and venturous. Thy age confirmed, proud, subdued, bloody, treacherous. More mild, but yet more harmful, kind in hatred. What comfortable hour canst thou name that ever graced me in thy company?
Faith, none but Humphrey Hour that called your grace to breakfast once forth of my company. If I be so disgracious in your sight, let me march on and not offend your grace. Strike the drum.
I prithee, hear me speak.
You speak too bitterly.
Hear me a word, for I shall never speak to thee again.
So.
Either thou wilt die by God's just ordinance, ere from this war thou turn a conqueror, or I, with grief and extreme age, shall perish and never look upon thy face again. Therefore, take with thee my most heavy curse, which in the day of battle tire thee more than all the complete armor that thou wearest. My prayers on the adverse party fight. And there the little souls of Edward's children whisper the spirits of thine enemies and promise them success and victory. Bloody thou art, bloody will be thy end. Shame serves thy life and doth thy death attend.